I always make videos about going to Halifax, moving to Halifax, living in Halifax. But what if you're moving away from Halifax? More specifically, what if you're leaving Halifax? What are you gonna do? What's the next chapter gonna be in your life? And I've been asking myself this. You know, I've been living in Halifax for 3 years and back in Lakefield, Ontario. And every single time I've come back here, here is basically my childhood home. It's the only place I call my childhood home, although I moved here when I was 13. People still think, and people have told me, like, their families have been here for generations. I've only been here for what, like 8 to 10 years now. So my family's opened a kennel, we've opened a business in the area, and you know, I went to school here, I grew up here, but I've never been in a house for more than 5 years. I think this is the only place in my life I've actually stayed for so long, though I have been going to university, so still I haven't really consistently lived anywhere for longer than 5 years. But I'm actually grateful for that, because I've had a lot of different experiences. I got uprooted a lot in my childhood, but I'm very grateful to have those new experiences. So I'm recording this, believe it or not, on my iPhone, and it really helps me, you know, pump out more videos, because when I use my camera slow to like record to render on my MacBook. Anyway, about leaving Halifax. I'm leaving soon, and I'm thinking about what I'm gonna do with my life. In fact, I know exactly what I'm gonna do with my life. A lot of people don't have the luxury of saying that. I'm gonna continue growing my business, and I wanna grow my online teaching business. I wanna help people, and that's why I'm making these videos every single day. I could be hanging out with friends right now, but I'm really, you know, trying to set myself up so that I have a good life down the road, and that I can, you know, if I ever have a family, I can help my family. So what I recommend doing, if you're leaving Halifax and you want to know the next chapter, like what am I going to do after university, you know, I'm down at Dalhousie or Acadia or St. FX or King's, and I don't know what I'm going to do, how am I going to get a job, what's going to happen, ask yourself, that's what I'm doing, what made you the happiest when you were a kid? I know you've been to university and it tends to change you. In fact, even if you entered university because of something that made you happy when you were a kid, like for example, I loved talking to people, so I went to journalism. I soon realized journalism wasn't silly in talking to people. Journalism was actually like, it was different. I mean, there was journalistic ethics, it's just different than what I expected. So it changed me a little bit because I've been in a institutionalized education system that's been teaching me their way for 3 years. It's a little cliche, but it's true. So basically what I ask myself is, hey, you know what, this degree's an experience, it's back up under my belt, and it's branding, but what am I gonna do in the future? You know, if I wanna become, you know, the best version of myself, and I ask myself, what made me happy when I was a kid? What did I like to do? And that was make videos, is make content, and actually just to make people laugh. That's something that's been really, like, you know, lacking in my content. I wouldn't say it's become about the numbers a little bit. I've been focused on that like once in a while, but really I've lost a bit of myself. So after school, I think it's an opportunity to like kind of rekindle that spirit I had when I was younger, to like record those videos, but also make a business out of it. So I want to enjoy what I do more. I love what I do, but a lot of it's been hustle and pushing, and I don't get to see a lot of people that I care about a lot because I'm working. And sometimes, like, you always want to feel like you're working towards something. So I'm gonna keep working this way for another year, and then when I'm done, I hope I've built up, like, you know, enough courses, enough books to be able to sustainably live off it. You know, move into a decent apartment. I'm gonna move out. This is my family's home. I'm here for a few months. There's no point in me renting somewhere. We're still renting in Halifax, actually. We're subletting it to my future roommate. But there's no point in me moving out of my parents' house right now to get a place for 2 months to go back and rent in Halifax, because I'll be doing two rentals at the same time, which is incredibly dumb. So yeah, so like I really have to think about where I'm going after school, and that's kind of what I'm doing. You know, this isn't like a preaching at you video, it's what I recommend, because I think we all lose that. Like, I felt it and I notice it in my friends, and yeah, we grow up, but I think we also, like, even though I'm hustling and like I always like pride myself on, I know what I'm gonna do next and I know exactly how things are gonna work out. I never know exactly how things are gonna work out, but like the fact that, oh, look at me, I'm still working at home. Like, I pride myself on that. Like, oh, I don't work for somebody else. I don't work a 9-to-5. It doesn't make me special. I still lost a lot of my not lost it, but you know, like forgot a lot of what it meant to be like a kid and to have that fun spirit. And I still have it deep down inside. I'm still a freaking idiot sometimes. But I got a lot of, I got really serious about it. So when you're leaving school, think about what made you happy as a kid. What made you happy in your life? Go ahead and pursue that thing and find a way to, you know, make that fulfill your life. I don't think you should leave it behind. That you're gonna get the degree, so it's gonna be branding under your belt. Even if you've left school and you don't have the degree, screw it, you know? I don't think I'm gonna actually be using it to get a job. So, as silly as that sounds, but I'm glad now, because if I didn't go to school and my life didn't turn out the way that I wanted, I would have blamed it on not getting a bachelor's degree, which is the stupidest thing to blame yourself for not being successful for, because you didn't go to school, you didn't study at school. It doesn't really actually have anything to do with that. Sure, school's a great way to help if you need guidance, but if you don't need guidance, you don't need to go to school. So, you know, it's everybody's gonna make their own thing out of it, but ask yourself, when you're done school, what makes you happy? Pursue that thing. You still have a ton of time, so I'm excited for you.